if you're already mining Bitcoins, why did you just purchase more Bitcoins?
So not only do we mine Bitcoin, but we mine things like Kaspa. And if you think about 1 kilowatt hour of energy results in about 8 cents of Bitcoin revenues. And 1 kilowatt hour of energy results in about a dollar of Kaspa. And so I can take Kaspa and sell it and buy Bitcoin. And so I'm essentially lowering my cost to buy Bitcoin.
If you're already mining.
So this video threw the Kaspa community into a frenzy. Is Marathon really just mining Kaspa to dump it off for BTC? The answer might surprise you. And I'll give you my answer in a little bit here. But first, before we get into what exactly is Marathon doing, are they bluffing? Are they trying to say things to keep the Bitcoin maximalist crowd happy? I'll talk to you about that. But first, congratulations are in order as Kaspa has made a new all-time high, currently sitting over 20 cents. Congratulations to all you Kaspians who've been holding on for a very, very long time, who have been proud members of the community. We take a look at the Kaspa chart here. Kaspa on MEXI, USDT on the one-day chart. Very similar price action here. You can see we see big moves up with Kaspa. In some of these moves, we see a little bit of consolidation for a few days. Again, this is on the daily. And then we lose about 61 to 75% of the move up. Consolidate, take another big move up, down, up, down, a little bit of consolidation. Typically, the drawdowns are anywhere between 60 to 75% as noted. Now, we are currently in an uptrend. And so we haven't been this high ever for Kaspa. So this is an all-time high, according to MEXI, where we're currently at right now. So how much higher could it potentially go? It could still go a lot higher. If we take a look at the last few big moves up for Kaspa and how the price action relayed, we saw the final candle on the daily before Kaspa started to have its drawdown. We saw a big wick to the upside, almost a reversal candle, and then Kaspa started to spill off. With the exception of this one, we saw a solid green candle, and then we saw bulls try to push the price up over 19 cents, failed, and the price of Kaspa spilled off. Same thing here. Bulls try to push the price up to 19.3 cents from an open of around 18.1 cents. A lot of volume came in, and ultimately, Kaspa spilled off. This again on June 29th. Solid green candle. Then we had a big wick to the upside. Now we are currently, now could this be the end, the final candle before we see a spill off? Potentially, yes. And if we do see a spill off, that 60 to 75% retracement should bring us right around this 17.5 to 18 cent level. If we throw on our VRVP, we see where are the bids coming in. You can see lots of trading volume between this 17 flat and 18.2 cent level, which also coincides again with the 60 to 75% drawdowns for Kaspa. But being in price discovery, we can go much, much higher, and that 70% drawdown could be down to this 20 cent level. So we wanna see how price reacts on the daily chart in this range, this new all-time high, this 20 cents. We throw on our Lux Algo price action concepts indicator. Some more confluence for us here on between that 17.5 and 18 cent level. A lot of orders coming in here with a lot of volume as well. And this is also where we got our buy order on our Matrix Oscillator. Now, at the very beginning of the video, I showed you Fred Thiel, the CEO of Marathon Digital, one of the largest publicly traded mining Bitcoin mining company, say, hey, look, we can mine Kaspa, turn around and sell it for Bitcoin. To which the community's like, yo, hold on, man, what's going on? Why would you mine it to sell it for Bitcoin, right? Some people believe Kaspa is better than Bitcoin. From a technological standpoint, I agree with them. Let's go back and look at the press release that Marathon Digital put out when they announced that they're mining Kaspa. So this is from their website, MARA.com. Marathon Digital Holdings announces Kaspa mining operations. This was back on June 26th. They announced that the company is mining the Kaspa token. In May 2023, Marathon began evaluating Kaspa as a potential way to diversify its revenue while continuing to utilize its current infrastructure and expertise in digital asset compute. You're going to hear that word a lot, especially with AI around the corner. But I think this green highlighted segment, which I'll make larger for you, I think this really answers the question of, hey, are they just mining to sell everything? So this is a quote from Adam Swick, Marathon's chief growth officer. By mining Kaspa, we are able to create a stream of revenue that is diversified from Bitcoin and that is directly tied to our core competencies in digital asset compute. There is that word again. So once their press release is saying we're looking to diversify away from Bitcoin, then Fred Thiel, going on an interview, says, yeah, we can sell Kaspa to buy Bitcoin. So what are they really doing? Is it lip service to the Bitcoin maximalist community? We know they have a big ties to some of the biggest maximalists, including Max Kaiser, some of the other ones I'm not going to really name. But if they're looking to diversify, what has changed from June 26th till now, other than Kaspa being up, other than KRC tokens coming into play, other than a new initiative that was launched, KII, K-I-I, and I'll go over that towards the end of the video, that is up and running. They're looking to get into the RWA. They're looking to get into the digital identity space. So what are they really doing, right? And on top of that, Kaspa is continuing to make all-time highs, and the technology is much better than what Bitcoin's is. So no, I don't think Kaspa is, or a Marathon is just mining Kaspa to turn around and sell all of it for BTC. They mine BTC. All they have to do is, hey, we're going to hold on to the BTC. We'll sell some for overhead. The thing with Kaspa as well is the overhead is a lot lower. So there's a lot less selling pressure needing to happen for them to be able to pay for some of the overhead that they need to keep the mining operations running. I want to point to this here from AUZ Ghosty, who might have found the wallet for Marathon, the Kaspa wallet for Marathon. Although this is not 100% verified, I did go through. I put this into the cas.fyi website. You can see here, this is the 18th largest wallet address with around 84.7 million Kaspa tokens, valued at around $17.42 million. You can see here all the different transactions, and all these are received from centralized exchanges, right? Received 14K in Kaspa, 36K in Kaspa, 17K in Kaspa. You can also click on this and you can see exactly what the transaction hash was, where it came from, where it went. You can see here the Bybit wallet got some, and also the Kaspa wallet that I'm showing you. And this came from this wallet address. So everything's the beauty of blockchain. Everything could be tracked. But if this truly is Marathon Digital's wallet address, I don't see a, hey, we're just going to mine a bunch of Kaspa and sell it all for BTC. You can see here on the left, the balance history. Sure, you see spikes and spikes to the upside and to the downside. You got to remember, this is a publicly traded company that is looking to make money, make revenue in profit. So of course they do sell some of their coins, but are they going to sell all of it for Bitcoin? I don't think so. And so I'm curious what you think. Let me know in the comment section. Are you worried that Marathon Digital is just going to mine a bunch of Kaspa and dump it all on the market for BTC? Let me know in the comment section. But there's so many exciting things happening in the Kaspa community. We had the KRC token standard go live, although it did have some hiccups. But fear not, because Kaspa fans, you have some of the smartest people in the digital asset space on your side, including Shai, one of the co-authors of the BlockDAG research paper, one of the co-founders of Kaspa. So this post here, this is back on July 11th, had a nice morning meeting with the Kasplex team where they updated me on their progress. On their agenda was changes to the KRC protocol, and he put proposed by myself and others that should streamline the process, make for an easier developer and user experience, and eliminate all the mass issues we have seen in the first open beta. I'll go over why that's important here in the next post. I'm going to show you a new and improved trust model that will allow new indexers to sync to the KRC network, an application of the new partially signed Kaspa transaction functionality introduced into the Rusty Kaspa to implement atomic swaps, the conditions for a healthy launch for the next open beta. We agreed that the launch should not be rushed, since its smooth operation relies on things that are outside of Kasplex's hands. In particular, the Rusty Kaspa team would like to see that most wallets implemented the RBF, which allows increasing fees for already posted transactions, and that is working as advertised. So it kind of sounds like they're maybe taking the Charles Hoskinson Cardano approach, and hey, We don't need to rush to launch a product. Let's make sure it works correctly, doesn't lose people money, and it gives people a great experience before we go into the next open beta. To which this latest post from Casplex: hi, everyone. We've made some optimizations to enhance the user experience. Wallets can now handle transaction mass issues more efficiently, which, if you want to go back, this is literally one of the things Shai said they talked about. Make for an easier developer user experience and eliminate all the mass issues. So that is fixed. KRC tokens can be transferred without costing a certain amount of CAS tokens, making airdrops and micropayments more cost effective. To help new wallets integrate these features seamlessly, we're launching a new test on Testnet 10. Stay tuned for more details. Highly, highly recommend you follow this handle here at Kasplex, KASPLEX, as you'll get all of your KRC and token issuance updates from there. Now, I talked about Kaspa, the project, the community, starting to delve into other sectors of crypto, right? You have the AI sector popping off, RWA, everyone's talking about it. DeFi, no one's really talking about it, but we know it's going to come roaring back. Well, this was just announced on July 18th, the launch of Kai. I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly. Kaspa Industrial Initiative, again, for press release on July 18th. What exactly is Kai? Transforming industries with Kaspa's groundbreaking block DAG technology, enhancing innovation, efficiency, and sustainability across finance, supply chain, energy, and the public sector. Kai is building a global network of leading companies supported by top industry players to drive the adoption of Kaspa's next generation platform. Their mission is to foster collaboration, set strategic direction, drive innovation, and enhance global adoption. Couple things here from their initiatives. Cross-border payments, which we know are a keystone of what a lot of people laud blockchain technology for, is, hey, stablecoins sending money to anywhere in the world for extremely cheap and extremely fast amount of time. They are looking to get into the sector, utilize Kaspa's high-speed, low-fee transactions to revolutionize international payments, significantly reducing costs and processing times. Talk about RWA tokenization. This is a massive one, with companies like BlackRock already pouring in hundreds of millions of dollars. You got Marathon behind you, mining Kaspa. So you're starting to get some of those tentacles to go out into these big players that you really need when you talk about RWAs, and Kaspa is working towards that. And I think Marathon mining it was a big step in the right direction. Enabled tokenization of physical assets such as real estate and commodities on the Kaspa network. We talked about DeFi, develop innovative DeFi platforms leveraging Kaspa's secure and scalable infrastructure, and stablecoins. Create and promote the use of stablecoins on the Kaspa network, providing a stable digital currency for transactions and savings, bridging traditional and decentralized finance, gives you ideas and ways they're looking to transform the supply chain, smart contract automation, integration with IoT, which is Internet of Things, and industrial digital twins. Talk about the energy sector. Proof of work has always been lauded as more secure and safe than proof of stake. The problem is it's not as scalable, right? It's just decentralized, not as scalable, right? The trilemma. Well, Kaspa from the get-go has always sought out to solve that blockchain trilemma: security, decentralization, and scalability. You can see here how they're looking to do that in the energy sector with the Kai initiative. Smart grids integrate Kaspa with advanced smart grid technology to enable efficient energy distribution and real-time consumption monitoring. Green finance and energy trading platforms develop decentralized energy trading platforms using Kaspa's technology, enabling peer-to-peer transactions between energy producers and consumers. What I love about Kaspa, the project, is this is all initiated, all created, all ran by the community. No one gets paid a dime from Kaspa, right? Think of it like Bitcoin. It was launched, fair launch, tokens, no VCs. People mined it. People are mining it. It's almost from the exact same playbook that Bitcoin had. Launch it and let this thing grow. We went from just regular people mining Kaspa like they did with Bitcoin to now you see, fast forward Bitcoin, you got some of the top mining companies in the world: Marathon, Riot, CleanSpark, you name it. They are mining Bitcoin. We already had Marathon announce. Are we going to see more? We're going to see maybe Riot, right? In this video, now this post here from Mr. Kaspa with the handle Kaspa Guru, Fred Thiel, in case you missed it, talked about how much revenue they make per kilowatt hour mining Bitcoin versus how much revenue they make per kilowatt hour mining Kaspa. And it's more than 10 to 1. More than 10 to 1. So 8 cents for Bitcoin, one whole dollar for Kaspa. And this number is only going to go up as Kaspa continues to enter into price discovery. Man, we are so bullish on Kaspa. And big shout out to the Kaspa team for providing some of the information I share with you in this video. If you like more Kaspa content, we have created a playlist for you. Everything Kaspa, and make sure to subscribe to Sin City Crypto and come check out our live show Monday through Friday at 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. See you in the next one.